So we know dogs get cancer, just like humans get cancer. It's oftentimes the same type of cancer that behaves in the same manner. Being a veterinary oncologist, my primary concern is your pet and making sure your pet stays comfortable and hopefully my treatment is successful. But the information we gain from my treating your pet can sometimes be extrapolated and taken into humans that have similar cancers. Companion animals live in a shared environment, so whatever toxins you might be exposed to in your everyday living, they are as well. Likewise, their biology and the biology of cancer is very similar to what you would have in a person. So it's more real, if you will. It's more appropriate. It's more applicable.
Brady was the sweetest German Shepherd you could ever meet. He was just a gentle giant. When we got the call that he had lymphoma, we were just floored. We were devastated. We tried so desperately to save him with treatments and with the chemo and the infusions. But in October 2012, he did eventually die. And then January 2013, I was diagnosed with lymphoma. It's the most devastating news that anybody can get, I think, is find out that you have cancer. I certainly never thought that I would ever get lymphoma like Brady had. But once I went to Dr. Evans, I think he's terrific because he made me feel just so positive. And I've been positive ever since.
I don't think doctors and veterinarians are too different. Obviously, the ultimate patient is different, but I think we're very much aligned in terms of interest, in terms of scientific discovery, scientific progress, and better outcomes, better survival, better quality of life for the patient, whether it be a small animal or a human.
Tufts University is very unique. We have a very strong cancer center at the veterinary school in Grafton, and we have a very well-established oncology program at the medical school in Boston, and a very strong cancer center at Tufts Medical Center. Together, we have shared interests, common goals, and from that, we've established a really strong collaboration.
My position here at Tufts involves both work at the medical school medical center as well as at the veterinary school. And so I go back and forth, I work in both locations, and my purpose is to try to build collaborative bridges.
We tend to form our alliances around particular cancer types, particular diseases. So my lab, for example, has an interest in bone cancer and osteosarcoma. Elizabeth's lab also has an interest in osteosarcoma. We strongly feel that if we put our heads together, compare them to each other, we'll find commonalities between those two studies, and that will help us laser in on the pathways and the targets for future therapies that are really important for those diseases.
You know, these are not mice that we are inducing cancer in. These are people's really beloved friends that they are bringing us to help them.
I brought my cat Ginger to Tufts Hospital because she had a large lump underneath her tongue. When I was offered the opportunity to have this clinical trial, we knew that it wouldn't save her. Squamous cell carcinoma is too difficult. She still was purring, she still enjoyed being pet. So I chose that route because I thought it would give her a little extra time, and it did. This trial was important because it not only gave Ginger a little bit of hope, but building from that research potentially could help other animals and potentially people who may have squamous cell carcinoma.
It only makes sense that you would use an animal that got sick to try to find out, okay, why did he get sick? Or why, like with myself and Brady, was there something in the environment, something else that could have caused both of us to get this disease? Brady was more than just a pet. I mean, he was a family member, and I think he deserved every chance to be cured, just like I am having every chance.
We all have that shared common goal to understand cancer biology, to improve our treatments, to improve our patient care. And rather than having it be veterinary patients, veterinary oncology, human patients, human oncology, to work together and make sure that everybody's benefiting in a very cohesive, organized, shared manner is, I think, personally going to revolutionize cancer care for both humans and companion animals.